I've been reading books of old, the legends and the myths, Achilles and his gold, Hercules and his gifts, and Spider-Man's control, and Batman with his fist. And clearly I don't see myself upon that list, but she said, where'd you wanna go?
Hey guys, Ron from FunctionBuilt-Aquatics. And today I'm attempting to try a new experiment with a tannin source that most people would not even think could be an option. So I read a few articles, one of which were from Red Wine Bettas, who actually used these Rooibus, I hope I'm saying it correct, herbal tea bags. And I picked these up from one of our local large supermarket chains called Wegmans. And I believe I paid less than $3 a box. I picked up two boxes, and there's actually 20 tea bags in each. So what I'm going to try to do is I'm going to attempt in trying to get some of the water in a few specific aquariums a little darker, a little quicker. And I like the option of using these tea bags versus constantly putting leaves in. I really like to keep the bottom of the tank as pure and as clean as possible. And I know it's really difficult when you utilize as many leaves as I do. So I'm trying this method to see if I can get the same effect. And I realize that you're thinking, hey, you can't put tea bags in your aquarium. This is not your standard tea. This is also a decaffeinated tea. There's nothing added to it. It's mostly a combination of the actual plant itself that produces the actual tea and the tannins. I'm thinking one bag per 20 gallons, and in this instance, it's a 20-gallon high that's filled about 3/4 high, so it's about 15 gallons. So I'm gonna try one tea bag in 15 gallons of water. I just did a pretty big water change where I drained most of the water out of one of my 20-gallon tanks. My four sheep have been spending a lot of time hiding, and I think a lot of it has to do with the fact that the water is gin clear in their aquarium. I haven't recently added any leaves to that tank because I've been very, very, very busy with the spawning that I have going on with the Una Immaculata in our collection. I'm not saying I directly neglected the four sheep, but I haven't been adding leaves to her tank. And I figured this would be a good option to try, test it out. And if it did work, I would try this on some of my other Cochina type species, like the Wojak and my Hendra. And if eventually I picked up or brought in some more of that particular complex, they do like dark stained water with low pH. So I'm going to see if this bag gets it done, drops the pH, and if it's a cleaner way of actually adding tannins to your water, and then just removing the bag when it's complete. So I'll get back to you. I'm gonna put the bag in, do a little time on it, and see how quickly it stains this tank. Stay tuned, FunctionBuilt-Aquatics. Okay guys, so this is how I'm gonna hang the tea bag for now. And it makes it easier to remove it. Tea bag's been in the tank for about a little over 2 hours or so. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put a leaf in there like so, just to hide it. Make sure the driftwood stays in place. I'm trying to get this driftwood to sink. Make sure you put the lid back on your wild betta tank. I've had a lot of people message me and tell me that they've lost fish, you know, and the lid was only off for a short period of time. So I don't know if you can tell right now from the first video, but let's see. There's one of the four sheep out right now. Yeah, definitely gave a little bit of color. So I think it's probably going to take two bags and a 15 gallons of water to get a nice tint to it. We'll see how long each bag lasts when they no longer become useful. My assumption is every 2 to 3 days, and then when you do a water change, then you'll just add another bag or two, you know, so you're talking like maybe once a week or so. Now, why do I want to do this? I love finding new ways to actually do different things. You can see the difference on the Hendra tank and the Forshee tank, and that was just within 2 hours. I love finding new methods to do different things with tanks, especially methods that are right under your nose that you just don't expect to work. I love using leaves and will continue to use leaves. As you can tell, I'm still using leaves. But I do not like when the leaves break down, the amount of mess they produce. And then you gotta go in there and you gotta basically siphon out the bottom. And in tanks with fry, that's impossible without sucking fry up. So with that being said, you know, maybe putting leaves in bags and hanging them. Yeah, you could do the same thing doing that. Acts like a big tea bag. But I just fell in love with the idea of doing something a little novel, something that was right under your nose and you just couldn't figure out, hey, that would work. And someone else did the legwork for us, Red Wine Bettis. He has a blog on the internet, fantastic information about a number of different complexes of wild betta fish. I would encourage you to go visit. I'll put a link on the bottom. But he's the one who actually put the article out that I got the idea from, and I'm just implementing it to my room and put it in my arsenal. Another way to bring a natural tannin and natural dark appearance to the water for wild betta fish. Thanks, guys. Thanks for watching FunctionBuilt-Aquatics.